Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today's video is about... anatomy, as it pertains to top surgery. How do you know if your anatomy is better suited for a minimal incision approach like the keyhole approach or the periareolar approach, or would you be better off with a procedure like the double incision approach involving a larger scar? In this video, I'm going to talk about the ideal anatomy for each of these procedures and why it is important to stick to a range of procedures that are appropriate for your anatomy. I'm also going to talk about some objective ways that you can actually measure yourself. And I want to try to simplify this. I want to make it easy for you to understand so that you can go home and measure yourself and try to figure out what procedure is going to be best for you. I'm going to focus on talking about two main categories of procedures, the minimal scar approaches like the periareolar and the keyhole, and mainly the double incision approach, because these are the two most commonly requested procedures and the most commonly performed procedures. There are many other options for procedures. There's the fish mouth procedure, the lollipop, the inverted T, the buttonhole, there are free nipple grafts, there are no nipples. However, there is a reason that the periareolar, the keyhole, and the double incision approaches are the most common approaches requested and performed. And the reason is that these procedures are some of the only procedures that are going to give you a very, very flat chest. Okay, so let's just get into it. You're going to get yourself a marker and a tape measure. It doesn't have to be a special breast tape measure, it can just be a regular one. And you're gonna find your sternal notch. This is really easy to find. It's in between your clavicle, right in the midline at the top of your sternum. It's this little V-shaped dip in your clavicle in the middle. And you're gonna mark that with a V. You don't have to use a Sharpie, you can just use a regular marker. So you find that little marker and you're gonna put a point at the middle between the V. You can literally feel the V on yourself and you're gonna mark it, okay? I'm gonna go do this right now in a mirror. Okay, so it's gonna look something like this, and you're going to take your tape measure, you're going to put the zero at the base of this V, okay? So right at the base of the V is where the zero starts. And then you're going to take the tape measure and you're going to measure all the way to the center of the nipple. Right at the tip of the point of the nipple, in the middle of the areola, is what you want to measure. And this is in centimeters, okay? And you should get something somewhere between 20 and 30 centimeters. If you have a lot of breast tissue, it can be closer to 40 centimeters. If you don't have a lot of breast tissue, it can be as low as 18 or 19 centimeters. Okay, and then the second measurement I want you to take is I want you to put the zero at the center of the nipple, and I want you to measure all the way down to the inferior part of your chest. Right where that fold is, where the inferior part of the breast meets the chest wall, it's called the inframammary fold. And you're going to measure directly to that fold, and what you should get is something between usually 5 to 9 centimeters. Those two measurements are the most defining measurements that are going to guide you as to how much extra skin you have. So for an ideal male chest wall, that first number, sternal notch to nipple distance, should be ideally around 20 centimeters. If you get an 18, 19, 20, or 21 centimeters on that first measurement, you're in pretty good shape. Your nipple is pretty high on your chest wall, meaning there's not a lot of extra skin at the superior portion of your chest. For the second measurement, the center of the nipple to the inferior breast fold, you want that to be around 5 centimeters or less. 3.5, 4 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 6 centimeters, you're probably okay. Anything more than 6, you probably have some extra skin at the inferior portion of your breast. Okay, so let's get into the anatomy. There are three main anatomical parameters that I look for in patients that are going to determine whether they're a good candidate for a minimal incision approach or for a larger incision approach like the double incision approach. Those three parameters are, number one, the amount of excess skin, number two, the nipple position on the chest wall, and number three, the amount of breast tissue in volume. Okay, so let's talk about the first two parameters because there's a lot of overlap between extra skin and nipple position. these two parameters kind of go hand in hand. Nipple position is the main determining factor as to whether or not there is extra skin on the chest wall. If there is any extra skin on the chest wall, you really would be better suited for a larger incision approach. If you can imagine a large breast with a lot of extra skin present, and you make a little incision around the areola, you have to remove all that breast tissue, and then there's going to be the skin envelope left behind. And if that skin envelope is significant, if there's a lot of skin there, it's not going to retract as we would like it to retract against the chest wall. You're going to have a floppy skin envelope, and nobody wants that. It doesn't look good. It's not an aesthetic look for anyone. Okay, so when I'm trying to decide if one of my patients has extra skin or not, I kind of divide the chest in half, and I look at the superior portion of the chest separately from the inferior portion of the chest. Kind of draw a line between the nipple, and I look at each portion separately. And the main measurement that I use to guide me when I look at the top half of the chest is that sternal notch to nipple distance, and that should be around 20 centimeters. If that's around 20 centimeters, 18, 19, 20, 21, you're good. That is a very accurate measurement and a very good way to tell if there's extra skin at the top half of the chest. Now, when I look at the bottom half of the chest, it's that second measurement, the nipple to fold distance. So those two measurements, the sternal notch to nipple distance and the nipple to IM fold distance, are the two most important measurements that are going to guide you as to whether or not you have extra skin present at both the superior aspect of your chest and the inferior aspect of your chest. If your sternal notch to nipple distance is around 20 centimeters and your nipple to IM fold distance is around 5 centimeters or less, you are likely a great candidate for a minimal incision approach, meaning a keyhole or a periareolar approach. And then the only difference between these two approaches is whether or not we are reducing the diameter of the areola. And you can measure your areola. You take the tape measure and you measure from the medial to the lateral border of your areola, of that colored areola skin. And if that's around a 28 or 30 millimeters in diameter or close to that, you likely don't even need that scar around the whole areola. You can probably get away with a keyhole approach where you just make an incision along the inferior border of the areola. There's also a little bit of shrinkage of the areola that happens after the breast tissue comes out. So if you're a little bit over 28 millimeters, there's still going to be a little bit of contraction of that skin of the areola. So you can account for that. Okay, so let's talk about the third parameter, the amount of breast tissue present, or the breast volume itself. If you have a significant amount of breast volume, first of all, you're probably going to have some extra skin present, because if you have a large amount of breast tissue, it usually pushes out on the skin envelope and you're going to see some extra skin around the nipple. It's unlikely to have a large amount of breast tissue with very minimal skin excess, just because of basic physics and just basically what happens to skin with that push from gravity. So often these three characteristics all kind of go hand in hand. So when you have a lot of breast tissue present, usually it's going to push out on that skin envelope and you're going to have some extra skin present superiorly and inferiorly. If you have a really large amount of breast tissue, if you have a very, very large volume of breast tissue, even if your nipple is in a really good position on the chest wall, it may be very, very challenging to remove all of that breast tissue through a very small incision. So you may be better served with an IMF incision in that case, or a vertical incision going from the inferior border of the areola down to the chest wall. Your surgeon's just going to have a difficult time removing all of that breast tissue through a very small incision. And it's important for your surgeon to be able to visualize all the tissue appropriately, because that's going to help your surgeon to create a uniform chest wall. Now, of course, there are some borderline cases where you may not have such a significant amount of excess skin and not a significant amount of breast tissue present, and you're hoping for a minimal scar approach, but you are kind of above that 20 centimeter sternal notch to nipple distance and above that 5 centimeter nipple to IMF distance. For those borderline cases where you're just slightly above, there are some other options that involve minimal scar approaches. I don't think they're perfect options, because anytime you try to take out a significant amount of skin, first of all, you are putting some tension on a nipple that is tenuous in terms of blood supply. So you have to be careful with how much skin you excise. You also have to think about how much pleating is going to happen, because when you try to excise a significant amount of skin around a nipple areola complex, you're going to have some pleating that happens as a result. Think about two circles and you're excising some intervening skin between two circles, and you try to close close a very large circle into a smaller circle or smaller oval, you're going to get some pleating effect, and that can look unnatural. So that's something to keep in mind. I think that it's better to have a larger scar that heals nicely rather than a weird contour or some weird pleating around a nipple and have a minimal scar. So I hope this was helpful for you. I hope you can take these measurements and these guidelines and measure yourself and try to figure out if you're a good candidate for a double incision approach or a larger scar approach versus a minimal incision approach. Please feel free to comment, ask questions. I'm happy to help figure it out for you if you're having trouble. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe.